Hi, and welcome to Tiger Art. Today, I'm going to start with a question. On a normal day, what color are leaves on the tree? Usually, we would say that they would be green. Well, in a few weeks, those colors are really going to change quite a bit, and that can change the way that we think. Believe it or not, colors have the power to really change the way that we feel. When we see red, orange, and yellow, for example, we may feel very differently from if we see blue, green, and violet, or what you might call purple. This is a difference of warm and cool colors. Some colors we would say would be warm colors, like red, orange, and yellow, or even brown. We learn this very early in life when we see something that's hot and we feel its heat, like a fire. Well, when we see something that's the opposite of that and is not hot, like blue, green, and purple, those colors opposites, we say that those colors are cool because they do not have the heat. In fall, we see mostly warm colors in the trees. When we see leaves that are red, orange, yellow, and brown, we think of that time of year. It makes us feel different than we would if we were looking at a picture with green leaves on the tree. For this project, we will be making a fall tree painting. We first need to know how to draw a tree, and let's look at a picture of a tree and just see how one works. The biggest part of the tree is going to be at the bottom. That's called the trunk. That part is heavy and big and strong. Why is it the strongest part? Because it has to hold up the rest of the tree. If it wasn't big and strong and heavy, the tree would fall over. As the tree grows upwards, it splits off into what we would call branches. So one trunk at the bottom may split off into two or three or four or even more smaller branches. The branches will get smaller as they go up. Why is that? Well, the reason would be that if the branches were too thick up towards the top of the tree, it would be too heavy and it would weigh the tree down. So a tree needs to be heavy and strong at the bottom, but it needs to get smaller and lighter out towards the ends so that the tree can stand upright. That's going to be important as we start to draw our tree. So for this project, we are going to need a plain blue piece of paper. We're going to use that paper going up and down, not side to side. You will also need a brown crayon. Put your index finger in the center of the paper. Then you're going to move your finger down towards the bottom. Leave some space at the bottom. Do not touch the bottom of the page. You're going to draw two straight lines going up, about this far apart. Then we need to make the roots of the tree. They will look like two mini skateboard ramps coming off the edges like that. I can imagine myself riding down one, dropping into a half pipe. I need to extend my lines up a little bit higher, but you'll notice that I am still below the middle of the page. I don't want to get too high. I want to leave space for the branches. Now going across the bottom, I want there to be a line, but I don't want it to be a straight line across. I want it to be a zigzag line so that it looks like roots coming up out of the ground. After I have that line, I can color in between my two trunk lines to make it a solid tree trunk with the brown crayon. You want to color pushing kind of hard so that when you paint the rest of this, it doesn't look silly with the crayon being very light and the paint being very solid. Now that I have a nice solid tree trunk, I want to start adding some branches. Now I know this is going to look a little strange at first, but I'm going to draw four lines. These lines should be a little bit wavy. You don't want them to be like completely straight, and you don't want them to be super duper wavy. You want them to just have a little bit of a wiggle to them. Once again, I know this looks a little bit strange, but trust me, it will look good in the end. After having the four main branches, look at this one here. Does it really look strong enough to hold itself up? No, it does not, because it's just a line. It's too thin. It's thin out by the top, and that's good because it's not very heavy, but down at the bottom it should be stronger. It should look like it can support its own weight. So I need to color next to the line to make it thicker, but only at the bottom. That way this part is stronger, but it gets skinnier as it goes so that it gets lighter and lighter. When I get to about halfway up the branch, like right there, then I leave it as just the line. So the bottom half is stronger, the top half is lighter and thin. It starts bigger and then it gets smaller and smaller as it goes up until it stops at about halfway. I will continue doing this with all of the branches. Coloring next to the line to thicken it and strengthen the branch only at the bottom, gradually getting smaller as it goes up until it becomes just the line towards the top. Now that I have my four main branches done, I want to add some branches to those. So coming up a little bit on each branch, I'm going to split off a new branch that comes off from there. This will make 8 branches, double the number that I had before. These branches also need just a little bit of thickening to strengthen them and make them look like they won't fall off. But it doesn't need to be as thick as you did at the bottom of the main branches, just about as thick as it is at that point on the main branch, so a little bit thinner than you started with before. Now those branches look nice and sturdy. I can split off and make new branches coming off of each one of those. That will once again double the amount of branches that I have, giving me 16 branches now. I can split each of those branches once again. Notice that I am not thickening any of these branches because I'm so far out on the tree that I didn't need to do that. This part of the tree, the branches are very thin so that they are light enough to stay up without falling over. The four main branches are big and they get smaller as they go out. I'm going to fill in this space in the middle a bit with another branch because I think it looks a little empty. You don't have to do that. That would be okay like that, but I just thought it would look better. That is the end of the tree drawing part for today. Next week, we will talk about painting in the colors.